I'm in the booth, bro. Give me 5 minutes.
God box.
Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist. Pump your black fist.
These crackers got drones, they flying, they saucers. Keep your white Jesus, don't pray to your crosses. They burning our churches, crit, pass me the Uzi. I know how to work it, I know how to squirt it. No Martin, no Luther, no King. No marching, no choirs, no sing. The same Christian lovers that raped their grandmothers and hung our grandfathers from trees. They enemies, blood on the leaves, blood on the streets, blood on our feet. I'm sick of walking, sick of dogs getting sick on us. I'm barking, I'm sick of spitting written sentences. Listeners, don't get, because they got chains on their brains, and that ain't no diss. Shout out to Tick.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist. Pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
I ain't African, I'm Ethiopian. Put them raw seeds in the fallopians. You can hope I win, ho, I hope I lose. Bitch, long as we made a trip, I hope again. I hope I get into heaven, I hope we forgive it. I hope Jesus, far as I know, look like near. Do I know when I see Florida heavens? Them sevens, I weigh in them sixes. I'm staying religious, cause we stay in the trenches. And got to play with they liches, then came to my senses. I bet them crackers never came through my fences. You burn up your cross and I burn up your corpse. And I turn and bang and do the same to the witness. Hang them and dangle them in the street looking up at his feet. So you never forget this, we did this for Martin and Malcolm. Even Mandela, Jimmy Lee Jackson and them nigga Evers. For Clyde Kinnard, hard labor, slaving in the yard. For Huey, for Hampton, for Bobby, we got it. For Jordan Davis, we gon' play this. For Sandra Bland, we gon' stand. I'm still out of stomping. For Janaea Thompson, from the coast to Compton, it's low.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist. Pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
Pump your black fist, pump your black fist.
I be trying, man. Like, this shit pisses me off, man, because especially when people come to me, man, I've been doing this shit most of my fucking life, dude. And then people get, I don't know, bro.
Yeah. This shit crazy, man.
Scott, talk to me, bro. You always calm me down.
Well, I just, man, it took me back to Ferguson, man. When you and I went to Ferguson and got on the ground around the whole Mike Brown thing. Mm-hmm. And just like you said, those revolutionaries were telling us that the black leaders were coming out for photo ops and they were leaving at sundown. Mm-hmm. But you and I stayed. Right. And when we stayed, a couple hundred police came down and started attacking innocent people. Mm-hmm. Right in front of our faces. And, you know, most people wouldn't even believe that something like that is possible in this country. But you and I lived it. And then mm-hmm. when we got back to the hotel, the news was showing footage from other cities saying that we were downtown Ferguson looting.
Yeah, the news was lying, bro. Like, lying, straight up
showing
lying.
Footage from other cities.
Yeah.
They were showing footage from Gary, Indiana, of people robbing liquor stores and saying, this is happening in Ferguson right now. And it wasn't just Fox. It was all of them.
So
you're right. This is a huge systemic problem. And then to go there, to have police put shotguns in your face, to have police pull 45s and call you a monkey and tell you can't stand still on the sidewalk. Mm-hmm. And then to come back home and see people, our own people, running around like there's no problem. It was mm-hmm. very disheartening. It makes it really difficult to participate in the movement, right? Because you feel like you're out there by yourself risking your life. And come back for what? For somebody to ask you, did you watch the latest reality show last night? You know what I'm saying? It was ridiculous.
Salih, what you think about all the stuff that's going on, bro? You have always have a tendency, man, to shoot it straight forward, bro. Like,
nah, I mean, I don't know, dog. Like, you know what's going on. Like, we see the shit, but it's like, I mean, that's with anything you do. Motherfuckers gonna keep doing shit until somebody do some shit about it. Like, if it was a spot, and that's with anything. If you knew you could keep robbing a bank and you wasn't gonna get caught, motherfucker, you probably gonna keep robbing that bitch. So everything is, you gonna do anything as long as you can get away with it. So that's just what it
And they know that they can get away with it with us.
Right, they know they can.
when there's no thought of, oh, I better not choke this man to death because of what his community or his family might do to me. That doesn't come into their mindset.
And not only what's not going to happen or the repercussions that you're going to have in the community, they know that the other black cops on the forces ain't going to do shit either. One of my greatest friends, he was a cop. He is a cop, and he stayed across the street from me. And he said, David Banner, there is no such thing as a good cop. And I said, what do you mean by that? You a cop. He said, because every cop know who the problem cops are.
They know who
those
the
white boys
cops are.
That whoop, that fine that you see on TV, them be the same white boys that be beating your ass every time they get an opportunity to. And all of the rest of the cops know who that person is. And we have so much motherfucking technology, we know where anybody stays. Like, and we so fucking tough towards each other. You let a motherfucker step on your shoes. Let a motherfucker step on your J's. You gonna do something about it. Let somebody do anything. But when it comes to our children or something happening to somebody else, you don't hear nothing from nobody unless it's from an outside perspective. What are you willing to give up? If you really want this shit to stop, you have to ask yourself right now, don't point your finger at nobody else, what in the fuck are you willing to do on your own right now? If nobody else is going to help you, if nobody else is coming, what are you willing to do? You, not nobody else, man.
And that's a good quote. That's a good answer, because I was just reading your live and someone just asked, I just said, we need a leader. And what you just said is an answer to that. Stop looking for someone else. What are you going to do? We're each leaders, or we mm-hmm. should be. So that's your answer.
And to be honest with y'all, the leader shit is so fucking played out. Why would somebody want to be your leader in the first fucking place? Any of the rest of the leaders, all they do is, the white folks will help build your leader up just so they can kill him or her and break your fucking spirit. The problem isn't the leaders. We've always had leaders. It's that no one agrees on what the points are. If you ask any other subsection of the world, what are they fighting for? They can tell you. Whether it's immigration, whether it's fucking marriage rights, whatever it is, you ask 10 black people, what are they fighting for? You're going to get 10 different fucking answers. We need to get out in the motherfucking, on the fucking block and roll some motherfucking dice or play some fucking CeeLo and pick some shit and just ride with that shit until we get it. We need to say what we are willing to do, and if somebody does something, and this is the thing too, I don't give a fuck if you black. Whoever you are, if you do something to an innocent black man, woman, or child, even if you black, if you a fucking alien, I don't give a fuck. If you got four titties on your motherfucking head, if you do something, then the same thing is going to happen to you. We ain't picking out no particular race. But I'll tell you something else one of my friends told me. And think about this. Ku Klux Klan members, they hate black people, Jewish people, gay people, right? All these different subsections of people. But you don't never see them fucking with no Jewish folks, do you? Now in America, you barely ever see them pick on a gay person. Because if you do, they're gonna find a way to ruin your fucking life. Whether it's physically or financially, like I told you all before. So that is the reason why they pick out and pick on black people. Because don't nobody do shit, period. What else we need to talk about? What else we need to talk about?
Question. Can you touch on supporting our own militia?
No, I ain't gonna touch on supporting our own militia because that's not the type of conversation that we need to have in the front. See, we end up doing those types of things and then shit gets blown out of proportion and the wrong people end up getting hurt over some shit. That's some shit that we talk about offline by ourselves and with ourselves. Like, one of the reasons why we created our company the way that we did is because we all decided that we were going to start doing what, Sully? Taking care of ourselves,
always,
right?
Always.
We got to start taking care of ourselves and define what we are willing to do. That's it. And tell motherfuckers, this is the last time you put your hand on a black person. If you do, because think about it. I always said this. Watch this. My dad had something. Scott, you remember this. My dad always used to say, he called it the Benz law. If you wreck my Benz, Don't tell me you sorry, motherfucker. Buy me a Benz. You kill my motherfucking child. Give me yours. Period. Period. And now, I'm going to ask y'all a question, man. Like, all these motherfuckers, bro. Like, I mean, everybody, man. Our churches, whoever, man. It's all of this. All this forgiveness shit don't work. Even Jesus went in the church and flipped over tables. Shit.
And it's crazy because...
Well, they preach to us those parts of the Bible that keep us docile. They don't talk about the other parts of the Bible that say, you know, if your cause is just, you can take a life. Or, you know, things of that nature. They only pick and choose the parts that will keep us complacent. But there's other parts of that Bible that will you know, really, really, really get right down to the heart of the matter. But those verses, you know, don't get the shine.
Man, them folks will do anything for their children, bro. And what's even crazy to show y'all that this shit ain't built for y'all, we got videos now, shit, and still can't get no fucking act right, dog.
Watch a black man get shot in the back and took two trials to get the guy convicted. That's two trials. He has a video.
Thank you, Scott. That's what I wanted to say. Bro, listen, Scott, and tell me if you agree with this. I'm sorry for cutting you off. If a cop's life isn't in danger, if a person is running away from you, there's no need to shoot. The danger is running away from you. All you are trying to do is catch the person. If a motherfucker don't have a gun or a knife, these white kids be swinging knives and guns and all kind of shit. They hit the motherfuckers with beanbags or some shit. Some bullshit. And integration is the worst thing that happened to black people. Period.
They didn't bomb Black Wall Street and Tulsa for no reason.
And I'm going to tell y'all, so we got to stop acting like the only time this shit happened is the shit that we catch on video. Bro, this shit happened in our hoods every fucking day, my dude. Every fucking day this shit happened,
because
bro.
They feel comfortable doing it. They feel comfortable that they can get away with it. And that's our fault. And like you said, black or white, that guy that's on video beating that elderly person, he should not feel comfortable in his own community right now.
Nowhere, bro. So this is what I'll tell you all, man. If y'all notice, I hadn't been talking about much politics. I hadn't been talking about, you know, who's been getting killed and posting. And I'm going to tell y'all why. This is the reason why. First of all, with politics... Politics isn't about religion. It ain't about what you feel. Politics is what you can write down on a sheet of paper. Role models, like they would say about Obama, role models, that don't give you nothing. President Obama gave the descendants of Jewish people who were affected by the Holocaust in America, he gave them $12 million, period. You can write that on a sheet of paper. Like, It's not about keeping somebody out of office. It's not doing this. It's not. No, it's what can you write down on a sheet of paper? What laws, how much money, how many jobs, what can you actually quantify? Until you can quantify something, it doesn't matter. Until you can make the people who make you feel a certain kind of way feel the same way that our families feel, it don't matter. And you are a fucking fool if you think that their mothers, fathers, uncles, and cousins is gonna bring justice to people that look like them. They are not. You sit around and wait on that shit, you a fucking fool. They just not.
Well, I mean, when has a person that has been in complete control said, you know what? We've been treating you unfairly for 500 years. We've made trillions of dollars off of you when you guys are still living in squalor. So we're gonna go ahead and give up this privilege. Give away all of our money. We're going to even the playing field so that you guys can dominate us like you would if things were fair. Mm-hmm. That's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Freedom has to be taken.
Yep. Freedom is not for free, and freedom is not peaceful.
No.
It's just not going to fucking happen.
No,
let me tell you.
No one has ever gotten their freedom that way.
These folks gave you God and don't have an inch of God in them.
No.
These folks gave you God. And they have never acted like Jesus. They have never acted like God. Everywhere these people go on this motherfucking planet, there's not one place that you can name any Aboriginal people on this fucking planet. The Tasmanian people don't exist no more. I'm sick of talking this same shit. I've been saying this shit over and over again since you met me. I've been saying this shit. Matter of fact, most of y'all motherfuckers think I just got woke. I've been talking this shit since Crooked Letters. You just don't fucking listen, dude. I've been saying the same fucking shit. Go back and look at the motherfucking Like a Pimp video. We ran the Ku Klux Klan up out that bitch. Like, man, like, dude, it's your responsibility. I always tell people the story of Jesus is so that you can bear your own cross. The deaths of all of these people is on us. It ain't on them. That shit is fun for them. Be clear. And I just get tired of fucking talking all the time. Because where we from, that shit lame anyway. Scott, talking, if a motherfucker where we from posting, talking all the time, that shit lame as fuck. If you ain't gonna do shit and you just talking all the motherfucking time, you lame as fuck.
And for people that be thinking like, oh, you just talking and you ain't doing shit, I seen you leave a lot of bread on the fucking table to stick to what you believe in. So for motherfuckers that feel you don't do shit, hey, I'm here to tell y'all, because it was even times I was like, damn, he a bad motherfucker for that one, because he stood on that shit.
Man, but the thing about them kind of niggas, I don't give a fuck about them niggas. Niggas that don't do shit always talking about what somebody else don't do. Fuck you, nigga. I'm sick of that shit. Them niggas that talk that shit, because motherfuckers that's really working ain't got time. Motherfuckers that's really working ain't looking at us no way. They somewhere working. A lot of motherfuckers be tripping because I don't know certain rappers. The reason why I don't know certain rappers because I'm in the studio. I'm not listening to other, I'm not consuming, I'm creating. So them kind of motherfuckers that talk about, I hate new motherfuckers. Motherfuckers that just learned about some shit, now they want to talk. That's what's wrong with the internet in the first fucking place. Nigga, if I never did nothing in my life, just the shit that we did do, be thankful that somebody gave a fuck. That's why I applaud Tip. That's why I applaud fucking Mike. They ain't get, motherfuckers think you make money off of being revolutionary. We don't make no money. We lose money. Be clear. I hate that shit. Fuck them niggas. I swear, with all, and y'all know I hate that word, fuck you niggas. They got anything to say about me. Nigga, you don't know me, and you don't want to know who I used to be. I be trying so fucking hard to keep my anger away from my people because white supremacy is so keen, and they not supreme. Fuck white supremacy. I said I was going to stop saying that shit. Them motherfuckers are so evil that they'll make you hate yourself. They'll make you turn around and hate the people that you fight for. And the only reason why people act like that is because of lack of knowledge and vision. So that's the reason why I understand the hate and just try to stay away from it. But right now, fuck them. Anything else y'all want to talk about? Well, it is class warfare to a certain degree. But at the end of the day, these white folk, when it come down to it, class warfare is the next level. We can't even get off of the sad thing about the war that we're fighting. We can't get past our own people. Look at the people who are great in our lives. Who took Pac? Who took us. Nipsey? Who took us. Lil Lonnie in Mississippi?
Us.
You feel me? So how can we? It's hard because you still got to defend yourself from your own people. Like the thing about white folks don't give a fuck if the white person is wrong. You know, you got some exceptions. You got a couple white folks out here that's decent. But for the most part, if you look at a cop who has been on the motherfucking television to show that he wrong, he's still getting $500,000, $1 million on his GoFundMe page. These motherfucking crackers see that Donald Trump is a motherfucking fool, and they still outwardly support him no matter how wrong he is, no matter how much he lies. And I actually respect that.
But we need to do that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. We need to black people talk about gun control more than other people. They we the sure only do. Motherfuckers talking about gun control. Let me tell you something about gun control.
We the only really ones without the gun.
Right. Let me tell you something. I'm gonna ask you a question, Lee. Do you think a thief or a gangster is worried about gun control?
Do I think either one?
Do you
of
think
them
they
are?
Gonna get their guns up?
Oh hell no!
You think cops gonna get their guns
hell
up?
Hell no!
So that means the only people, if they did have real gun control, the only people that's gonna be affected about it are the victims who get terrorized by both of those groups of people. You better find a way to get you a motherfucking gun. Ain't nobody gonna give you no Scott, I'm sorry we cut you off. What's the name? We couldn't hear nothing that you said. Like the whole thing went out.
It was distorted.
It was real distorted. So what I'm trying to tell you guys, man, is we looking for somebody else to defend us. And I'm going to tell y'all, my career really didn't take off until I realized it's on me. Everything is on me. Everything is on. I got to defend my people. That's the reason why we didn't take off doing this COVID shit. We got people in this bitch to pay. We got cameras and shit to pay for. We got people, man, fuck that shit. You take off. I'd rather die from COVID than fucking being hungry and homeless in this bitch.
Word.
Or one of y'all fucked up. We don't give a fuck about black life, so why don't we ride then? Why don't we fucking ride? Niggas ain't as tough as they say they are. If they did, bro, they wouldn't discriminate. If you pimp every fucking thing in this bitch. I don't give a fuck what color. If it got a hole, you pimp that motherfucker. But now we tough towards who we want to be tough towards. That's some coward shit to me. I didn't get on here to really, I'm going to be honest with y'all. I didn't get on here to talk about this, man. The reason is because this ain't nothing that wasn't said about Emmett Till. What, this same thing that was said about Mike Brown. It's the same thing that was said about Philando. You pick it. We've said this shit all fucking ready. Like what the fuck you want to do, period. What the fuck you want to do? That's it. Tell me. Anything else? How do we recover psychologically as a people? First of all, we have to find out that we're sick in the first place. Most of us don't think we're sick. Most of the things that we think is white folk shit, we created. Therapy is very important. I think every black person on this planet, every African person needs therapy because of white supremacy and what white supremacy has done to us. You know what I'm saying? So, like, for me, I honestly think if the biggest answer to every one of these questions is self. We got to take care of self. We have to love self. I really honestly, bro, and people get mad when I say this, I don't think most black people love being black. If you did, you would die for it. Most people ask me why I'm not scared, because they're killing you anyway. When Trayvon was murdered, what was he doing? He was walking down the street. He wasn't fucking with nobody. So you might as well fight. They're killing your black ass anyway. Man, look. Yeah, we definitely need some psychological help. But I think that some of our behaviors are so normalized that we actually think that we're healthy and we not. You know what I'm saying? That this shit is, the fact that we can watch somebody get elder lady get her head bust open and we pulling out our phones before we put our foot in the motherfucker ass is a problem. The fact that you filming something and ain't doing something tells me something about you. If you got a motherfucking camera up, I'm just technically saying, same way you raised your phone, you could have raised the pistol. You could have raised some fucking attention to get some fucking help. You could have raised the foot in somebody's ass. Same way you raised that motherfucking phone. You keep doing the same shit over, you the fucking fool. I had to learn that in relationships. Like, dude, if my dad used to always say, I know y'all get tired of this. The first time, you didn't know. Second time, maybe you forgot. The third time is fuck you.
It's on you.
So this shit's on us. And I'm tired, y'all. I've been tired. I fucking been tired, dude. That's why I appreciate, I say this all the time, I appreciate y'all. Like, people that's around me is the people that I depend on. Cause I always say that shit all the time, bro. Motherfuckers love me, but they don't love me like they love Pop. They ain't do nothing about that. They love me. They don't love me like they love Malcolm. They ain't do nothing about that. They love me. But they don't love me like they love Martin. They ain't do nothing about that. They love me. And they said they thought that Jesus was the Son of God and let him stay up on the cross. So what the fuck you think they're going to do to somebody else? Black people or African people, whatever we call ourselves, are going to have to show people until we love ourselves. We have to love ourselves so fucking much that if anybody does it, And all you little motherfuckers out here saying that, well, black on black crime and all, you a fucking sellout. Because it ain't the same. I could talk about Saleh all fucking day if I want to. I could punch Saleh in the face right fucking now. You do it, I'm going to shoot you. Period. No, seriously, dog. Motherfuckers can talk about your sister all day. You can slap up and whoop on your sister and bully your sister all day. Let another motherfucker touch your sister, right or wrong.
I feel you. Yeah.
Me and you joke all the time. Don't nobody joke with me like you joke with me.
Yeah, I know.
But somebody else joke with me, what's going to happen to them? I'm going to beat their fucking face in. So until we love ourselves like that, man, that shit ain't good, man. Y'all keep talking about celebrities. What about you? Why the fuck you keep asking about celebrities? That's our fucking problem. Malcolm told y'all that. Fuck celebrities. Fuck celebrities, dude. Most celebrities get paid for shit to be exactly the way that it is. And most of us don't support celebrities anyway. You ain't buying shit. So they getting paid by the fucking system. You ain't buying shit. So why the fuck would you constantly think a celebrity is gonna help you? These motherfuckers don't give a fuck. None of them. And the reason why they don't give a fuck is because you don't give a fuck. Why would you expect any celebrity to put their life on the line and you won't? That's stupid. Stop that shit, man. And most of these celebrities are on some white folks' fucking network. They can't do but so much anyway. And if they started their own network, you ain't gonna support the motherfuckers. It ain't Netflix. It ain't MTV. I'm serious, my dude.
I know you.
It's our fault. This shit is about us, dude.
It ain't Netflix.
Yeah, who saves the hero? You fucking right about that shit. Man, I'm so sick of that shit, man. I'm sorry, Corey. Say something positive, Corey.
Well, right now we have an opportunity here. And that opportunity is to really unite and come together and strategically work on things to really affect change. Like, it's one thing, we're all angry right now. We're all upset. Like, it's almost like watching a movie and seeing the villain do something just nefarious. Like, it's our instinct as humans to be emotional, to be angry. And we're all angry. And some people like to see destruction. Some people, you know, say an eye for an eye or this and that, but it's always the cooler heads that prevail. It's always the ones that say, okay, amidst this chaos, let me fall back and let me meticulously put together a plan that can really affect lasting, meaningful change. And so I think that that's the opportunity, and I think that's the thing that we need to focus on and put our energy into. You know, channel that anger into something productive and meaningful.
Let me tell y'all something else, too. I want y'all to know about from my perspective. Let me tell y'all something. I think about my unborn children a lot. And I look at how people that fight for white people, they die rich. People who support other communities, those people die rich. Why do the descendants of Africans who treat you like a king and act like they're generals for you, they always die broke and lonely? Malcolm died. I did a comprehensive study on Malcolm X. He died with $250 to his whole entire name. And then we talk about the sacrifices. I see all these sports figures. They're always talking all this stuff about, you know, Black History Month and thank you for all the sacrifices. But don't nobody want to sacrifice nothing. One of my heroes, he told me, it's one of the reasons why I didn't sample on the last album. He said, David Banner, if you're always sampling, then what's going to be left for your children? You got to make some new music so that they can have something to sample. And that's the same way with sacrifices. If our generation don't sacrifice and the kids' generation don't sacrifice, then what's going to be left for their children? Who's going to benefit? Everything is about what you are willing to fucking sacrifice, my dude. And I don't want my children to fucking be broke, man. My family fucking suffer. People don't have no idea what I went through during Katrina. like my whole 50 Cent sent clothes, man. He sent so many clothes. All that was in my mom's house. You know, I had the hottest record that I had in my career, and I didn't tour because I was in the waters of Katrina and helping people. And then as soon as that shit was over, and I didn't do it for no pats on the back, but motherfuckers left me. And until I made Get Like Me, motherfuckers didn't support or help. Didn't nobody want to play nothing. Until I fucking took that record to Big Von in the Bay, stood up, motherfuckers left me alone, dog. Let's be clear. Motherfuckers talk all the shit. I left here, I left there. Bro, when I got my motherfucking deal, I went back home, homie. And sat out there for 2 years, bro. Didn't nobody fuck with me, period. Fucking, if you go look at the approval rates of both Malcolm and Martin, the year before they died, they were hated by their people, both Malcolm and Martin. And we talk that shit when somebody died. I don't want that shit. Fuck that. And the way that you spend your money and the way that you act, how you react to something, shows your love. Don't tell me you love being black and you don't spend with black people. Don't say that you love black people and black kids are dying and hungry all around you every fucking day. Like Pac said, it's churches all over the motherfucking black community, but ain't no homeless people sleeping in just about none of the motherfuckers. Love is what you do. Love is what you sacrifice. All that shit, man. Fuck. White people always want to know what they could do to help in the fight against racism. What can they do? It's two things, and I got this from Killer Mike. One is stop the ignorance in your groups. If you're learning knowledge from David Banner, Killer Mike, any of the people that's online or your black friends or whatever, take that shit and spread it in your community. Because you know you got racist white folks around you. And if you let that shit ride, you a fucking racist ass cracker too. If you lay up under that shit, that's just like if I'm on tour and I see a girl getting raped in my motherfucking room and I don't do nothing about it. Well, they gonna send our ass to jail anyway because we black. But I just mean that's part of my responsibility because I see it and I let it happen. And to walk away from that shit mean you a cracker too. The other thing is, if you have an opportunity to open the door for a black person and let them through, I ain't even asking you to create nothing for black people because that's our relationship. To be honest with you, if white people really, let me tell you something, Caleb Muhammad taught me. He said, David Banner, all the highways, all the buildings out here, if you did, check this out, Tommy, you're going to like this. If you didn't do nothing, if you didn't touch none of that shit, right, what would happen to it? Yep, the highways and everything. If you didn't drive on them or didn't touch them, what would happen? Grass would grow. It would turn back into the forest. If you leave God alone, God will be God. If they fucking leave black people alone, we would get the shit together. Every time they ever left us alone in history, Black Wall Street started popping up. We started getting our shit correct. Think about this. As soon as black people start getting conscious, white people start making Black Panther and start putting black people in more black movies. So it would give the illusion that we're getting forward. But what it's really doing is thwarting your ability to get at your fucking self. Leave us the fuck alone. That's what you do. My opinion. Just do what the Jewish people did. Do what the fucking Koreans do. Shit, you know what we did in high school? We didn't understand. We copy off the fucking paper, right? Copy off the fucking paper. Buy your own shit. This shit easy, dog. This shit ain't hard. Shit ain't hard, man. Yeah, we must pool our money. Yeah. But why don't y'all just most people gotta admit they wanna be a cracker. They do. Anything else? I'm ready to go home, man.
You ready to go home?
Any more questions, y'all? There are no health insurance companies. Is that what we... Yeah, baby, that's so many steps away. We need a grocery store first, baby.
you need things that sustain life, not support death. Because if I own that, you know, shit. One of the things that I tell people all the time is if you really want to help black people, grow food. That's one thing that I really do think that the South, one of the ways that the South is failing the revolution is I think the South should be growing food. And most of our children are not interested in getting out. We'll stand on, we just talked about that the last episode. We'll stand out in the heat all day and sell dope, but then complain about being out in the fields growing crops, something that will sustain your life. I think the West Coast should be on technology. You know what I'm saying? I think that the Midwest can open back up some of them, like how the Arabs are doing in Detroit. You know what I'm saying? East Coast, you know, shit, bro, that's an influence of media, period. You know, but we sit around and talk about where the fuck we from and don't own no land nowhere.
And not only do we need to grow our own crops and mm-hmm. things, we need to teach the children. Like, yep. It needs to start there.
Yep. I love y'all, man, with all of my heart, man. And I'm very zen. Like, the reason why I get angry today is I'm sick of talking. I'm just fucking sick of talking all the time. That's why I created a banner vision. That's why I may not pay y'all what y'all worth, but I pay everybody but Scott. But I got a running tab with Scott, though.
Why'd I log back in just in time to hear that?
I didn't know nobody.
And I realized, man, the best thing that I can do is employ black people. You know, and the more that y'all support me, the more that I can do. Like, we got so much stuff on deck, but like, I can say that people support me more than most people who make the sacrifices I do, but it don't be enough. Like, you know how much money I put on the line. I put up $30,000 just to have this podcast because I didn't want to sell out. I didn't want to be owned by any white conglomerate who would stop me from saying what I want to say. You know what I'm saying? And so I put $30,000 up. Just about anything that other people talk about what I do, I can show you the receipts of what the fuck I do. I can show you how many jobs I turned down, how many times my life, how many death threats I done had. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Scott, you know, you took care of my life, bro, for most of my fucking career, bro. People don't know about the death threats. And I ain't the type of motherfucker to get up and talk about that shit. It don't matter in no way. Because if I told motherfuckers, they ain't going to do shit no way.
Nope, and we not stopping, so it don't matter.
Hey.
Someone just said, how can I invest in a banner vision?
Oh, www.davidbanner.com.
One more time.
www.davidbanner.com.
We need to start supporting our own businesses. There are a lot of them out there. We highlight a few, but everyone needs to seek them out, and we need to support each other.
Mm-hmm. The other thing that I'll tell you all, too, these children will do anything that will help them feed themselves. You guys, when I first went on tour, I took 8 people out of Jackson, Mississippi, and 6 of them were selling dope. I told them I wouldn't be able to give you as much money as you were making on the streets, but I can give you a plethora of opportunities, and you'll have enough money to sustain your families, and you can find another business through traveling the world. And all of them went. Every one of them went. Not one of them turned it down. You just got to offer these kids something. You got to stop telling these kids about hope. I don't believe in hope. Don't tell me about no fucking hope. Don't tell me about no fucking belief. None of that shit. White folks tell y'all about heaven, but they building the heaven right on top of your ass. They take our hoods, and within 7 fucking months, they turn it into their fucking heaven. I don't believe they believe in God. Because if they believed in God, they wouldn't do things to people that they do. I'm going to tell you something that people laugh at me about. I have very violent tendencies. But Lee laugh at me all the time because I don't be wanting to kill animals no more. I feel like everybody has a right to live. Because that's God's law.
everybody, like we kill all these animals for coming in our yard, but we never noticed that. Don't I stay in a forest?
We're in their territory.
I'm gonna shoot that woodpecker.
Well, that woodpecker is off the chain.
Like I stay in the fucking forest. We actually bulldoze they shit for our houses. But the rest of these, the motherfuckers that do something to us though. All right, y'all, love you. This is the David Banner Podcast. And we like to always end the show with a message from our ancestors.
I want to speak on mood, mindset, and perspective. The reason I pick those three things to talk about, that's what keeps me straight on a daily basis. If you're striving for something, man, you want to make sure you have an awesome, calm mood. You're in that mood. And your mindset will be more clear, and your perspective is broad. When your perspective is smaller, that because your mindset is jaded with jaded thoughts of being in a bad mood. That's why I always speak on positive vibes, positive mindset, reinforcement of those three. Because life is definitely what you're making. It's short, it's sweet, but you have to make a plan. Be visible out there. Be unstoppable. And ultimately, be great. Life is most definitely what you're making. Do not waste time waiting on people to do things for you. Do it yourself. Get out there. Get after it, man. Love life. Be a decent human. Have an awesome day.
Thank you for supporting the David Banner Podcast.
If you're frustrated with misleading labels and have been seeking truly all-natural products that won't break your bank, then search no further, as Live, that's L-I-V, with Nature all-natural products will take care of all of your essential needs. Live with Nature offers all-natural products that combats body odor, eliminates bad breath, and stimulates hair growth. Live with Nature all-natural products are handmade, vegan, and budget-friendly. That's what I'm talking about. When you respect nature, nature will respect you. To start your all-natural body, home, and hair care journey, visit www.livewithnature.com. That's L-I-V, livewithnature.com. Use the code DavidBannerPodcast to receive 10% off. Subscribe online or follow Live with Nature on all social media platforms for latest releases. Thank you, the David Banner Podcast.
If you're sick of bullshit TV that's always showing our people in a negative light, if you're looking for information that's simple and entertaining instead of boring, check out Business Bully TV. Business Bully TV has amazing programming from celebrity interviews, documentaries, and movie reviews. You can watch exclusive programming that you can't get anywhere else from today's power players. Business Bully TV is available for free on Amazon Fire TV, Roku, and streaming 24/7 and on demand at businessbully.tv. Once again, this is David Banner from the David Banner Podcast.